Hello everyone, my name is Andres Suazo. I'm the product marketing specialist for the ILC2050 BI, Phoenix Contact's version of the Niagara controller. I'm going to show you how to access diagnostic information from the controller without using the workbench software. This is useful when you want quick information, such as testing your IO. To start, you will need a cable with standard USB to USB mini. The USB mini connects directly to the USB port on the controller. After connecting the mini USB, a virtual driver is created that allows you to view diagnostic details via a web page. Now you'll need to open a browser. I'm using Google Chrome and type in the IP address 172.16.0.10:8080. The next view provides details on the controller. Log into the controller. Now you can find the host ID of the controller and view the current runtime of the Niagara controller. Network information is available too, such as IP addresses for both interfaces. This controller has two network cards, and the IP address can be configured separately for whichever interface is needed. Setting the date and time is possible depending on where the controller pulls information. This could be via NTP or configured manually. Looking at the switch now, since the controller has two network cards, you can allocate depending on your system needs. So if you want to have one primary port and then three Ethernet ports associated with the other NIC card, it's possible. You can do 2-to-2, you can do 3-to-1, or you can do all four to the Ethernet ports connected to the primary interfaces. The controller also supports Rapid Spanning Tree, a network redundancy protocol. One of the main features you will appreciate is viewing the current status of I/O running on the controller. This is useful when testing the controller and I/O response, verifying the devices are correctly wired and so on and so forth. Here we have some digital outputs and inputs, RTD cards, analog inputs and outputs. We can use this program to test outputs, to turn them on or off, and to change the settings back to auto. Testing digital inputs can also be done when connecting the input to the controller. Simply refresh the page. You'll notice now that I have a digital input being powered by a sensor. I hope this video gave you helpful information about getting diagnostic info on the 2050 BI. If you'd like more information, please watch our other tech videos on the ILC2050 BI controller or visit www.phoenixcontact.com/niagara.